to the man who has travelled the world to hear from amazing people who've used brain power to heal their illnesses and injuries. Dr. Norman Doidge investigates the brain's ability to change and joins us from Toronto in Canada.
Thank you very much, Sarah.
Doctor, there's no cure as yet for Alzheimer's disease, the most common form of dementia, but you say people can reduce their risk of dementia.
Well, we've had a very, very important study that came out just really a couple of years ago that was done with the Cochrane Institute at Cardiff University in the UK, which followed 2,200 men for over 30 years. And if they did these five different things, they reduced their risk of dementia, including Alzheimer's, in the population by a staggering 60%. These were men who walked about 2 miles a day, 5 days a week. So they walked to work, or they rode a bike about 10 miles. So exercise, physical exercise, for reasons I can explain, was the strongest predictor of decreased risk. Now, there's other things you can do to lower your risk of Alzheimer's, like not getting a lot of head injuries, for instance.
Doctor, can you give us an example of a surprising recovery that you've seen?
One of them that comes to mind is the story of a nurse practitioner named Jerry Lake, who was athletic. She was a nurse midwife. She ran a team. And one February day, she got into a motor vehicle accident. She was riding her bike and had a traumatic head injury. Serious brain injury, and for 5 years she made no recovery whatsoever. She was able to use this non-invasive technique, which involves putting a little bit of very, very mild electrical stimulation on the tongue to fool the tongue into thinking it's being touched. The tongue is just like a few centimeters in front of the deepest part of the brain, called the brainstem, that coordinates and controls much of the body. And literally within about 22 minutes, this woman who couldn't walk was completely overwhelmed just by turning her head, because that put her off balance. And she had a problem in the deepest part of her brain. And she was actually helped non-invasively. You know, no surgery was required, no medication was required. We're learning how to speak to the brain in its own language, the language of its electrical firing. And I find that, as a physician, very, very exciting.
Wow, that is just amazing. And what about the connection between brain and pain? Because pain can last even after the injury has been recovered from.
Let's say you have a nerve in your back and it's constantly being pinched over and over and over again. Over time, the brain gets so good at detecting that pain, it becomes hypersensitive, and the slightest movement can trigger the pain, and the pain will last not like for a second or a few minutes, but it can, in a chronic pain syndrome, spread out through the body and last very long. So in a chronic pain, what you do is you have damage not only to the body part, but in a way the pain system itself is becoming hypersensitive and damaged in its own way.
Right, so you're not saying that people should stop taking medication altogether, are you?
We have new approaches that don't involve medication. You should never go off medication without speaking to your doctor, but hopefully doctors over time will become more informed about these non-medication-based approaches. In some situations, these non-invasive approaches are used with medication, but sometimes they can be used without medication.
Dr. Norman Doidge, thank you so much for joining us. We do appreciate it.
Thank you very much.
And next month, Dr. Norman Doidge is conducting workshops in Brisbane, Sydney and Melbourne. For full details, go online to byronclinic.com.